Tonight, Ric Flair, three times National Wrestling Alliance World Heavyweight Champion, will be putting that title on the line against Wahoo McDaniel. But tonight, rules will be slightly different. This will be a 2-out-of-3-fall match with a 1-hour time limit. Wahoo McDaniel says there's not a man in the world that can defeat him 2 falls in one night.
First of all, let's get one thing straight. Forget about being three times. I'm the current World Heavyweight Champion, the only World Heavyweight Champion, and that's all that matters right now. Tonight, right here in Tampa, Wahoo McDaniels, you got the match you wanted, 2 out of 3 falls. And if you tell the whole wrestling world that there isn't a man alive that can beat you 2 falls, I'm just going to have to prove you wrong. I'm the greatest conditioned athlete alive today. I'm Ric Flair, the world champion, a living legend. And right here in Tampa, Florida, woo, Wahoo, I'm going to take it to you, brother, all night long.
Well, that all remains to be seen very shortly.
All right. All right, there you have it, the comments from Ric Flair, and the Road Warrior still in the ring. We'll be back in just a couple of minutes.
Tonight's sports special, Battle of the Belts, is being brought to you in part by Champion TV. Rent to own the stereo, television, or appliance of your choice, the Champion way. And by Schlitz Malt Liquor, the Bull. For a taste that's big and smooth and bold, the Schlitz Malt Liquor Bull. Battle of the Belts.
This is it. 2 out of 3 falls tonight. We are the number one contender of the National Wrestling Alliance Heavyweight Championship. For tonight, it's Ric Flair, and your thoughts on it.
Well, you know, John, I got a 2 out of 3 fall match. I can't scream. It's my type of setup. I had to do a lot of screaming, hollering. I believe the fans need to know who the best man is. I said the best way to find out is 2 out of 3 falls. And like I said today, I don't think there's a man in the world today that can beat me 2 falls in one night. I know Ric Flair's ready. I know he's a great champion. But I think it's time for a change, and I can't think of a better place for a change than right here in Florida.
We're going to find out in just a few minutes.
We're going to find out right after we pause for these important messages. As he approaches the ring, we'll wait for him to get into the ring, and then we'll be back with the introductions after we pause for a couple of very important words.
This is the National World Alliance Heavyweight Wrestling Match. 2 out of 3 falls, 1 hour time limit. The referee for this title match, Bill Alfonso. Introducing the challenger from Oklahoma, weighing 260 pounds, a former Miami Dolphins professional football player, Chief Wahoo McDaniel. Weighing 245 pounds from Minneapolis, Minnesota, the world's heavyweight wrestling champion, Ric Flair. 2 out of 3 falls, 1 hour time limit.
All right, there you have it. The 10 pounds of gold on the line. It's for all the marbles. You see that gold around the waist of the NWA World Heavyweight Champion, Ric Flair. Flair now removing that $5,000 robe and very carefully taking it over to ringside. He is cautious about who handles his garments. He is a jet setter, no question about it. Mike, I know that you had talked to Wahoo earlier in the day. Wahoo has all of the pressure in the world on him right now. To get a 2 out of 3 falls match through special dispensation of the NWA is a rather rare occurrence.
You're exactly right. I know the excitement that's going through Wahoo right now. I know how Ric Flair's thinking. He's cool. He's confident. He's been down this road 1,000 times. And right now, he's looking at 1 hour. He is the champion. Wahoo's going to have to go after him.
Do you think then that Flair might take that approach? Do you think he might get on his bicycle?
I think definitely that would be the best thing for him to do. He is the champion. Wahoo is is heavier. I think Flair is probably in a little bit better shape. And Wahoo does have to defeat him. Flair does not have to beat Wahoo McDaniel. If they wrestle to an hour draw, Ric Flair still leads the world's heavyweight champion.
Precisely. All right, Flair tantalizing his man, taunting him just a little bit. And so it appears that this is going to be the strategy. Flair is going to figure that time can be on his side. They finally lock up collar and elbow. He bowls him back into the turnbuckle and a good clean break. So Flair didn't want to keep too much contact going.
Well, you know, Flair wrestles the top competitors all over the world every week. And he's in unbelievable shape. That can wear you down. It can take its toll. On the other hand, you are in the ring so much that you make moves without thinking about them. You do things almost subconsciously, and that's one advantage that he might have.
Top wrist lock now by Flair and McDaniel, and it's Flair getting the advantage. Wide stance, Flair down on one knee. McDaniel down on one knee, I'm sorry. And it's Flair again, wide stance, and Wahoo McDaniel beginning to take the edge here. Tremendous test of strength and will and balance. And it is McDaniel taking the measure.
Well, of course, Ric Flair having that explosion strength, having those quick reactions. Wahoo is a different style wrestler. He's determined. He's constantly on you. He never gives you a chance to rest. He's just an incredible athlete.
Flair, an earlier old laceration, apparently has opened up, and it is Wahoo McDaniel bringing him back up against the turnbuckle. McDaniel keeping him in close, and Alfonso trying to keep them separated. Tremendous responsibility lies with the official in this match, too. Two out of three falls, and Flair trying to intimidate the referee. Alfonso may give away some size, but he's not going to be intimidated.
You know, you're right. And I tell you, like you say, officiating in every sport is questioned. Calls in football and basketball, and if a man was safe or out playing baseball, the officials in every sport has their job cut out for him, and it's one that I wouldn't want to have.
Amen to that. Chop, and it's a return chop by Wahoo McDaniel. Pardon me, and McDaniel exploding on Ric Flair. Flair backing away. Now, if McDaniel can get Flair mad, there's a possibility Flair will make a mistake.
Well, you know, that you're all right in your thinking, but Flair has so much ability, so many matches and time in the ring. That's almost impossible to do. Wahoo right now is just beating on him. Simply, plain and simple, beating on him. That's what he's going to have to do. He's going to have to hurt Ric Flair to the point of Flair not knowing where he is. Of course, taking that way out, like I said, Flair is a cool operator in the ring. He knows when to go to the floor. He knows when he needs to take a rest. He's not going to do anything foolish and take a chance on losing that title.
Flair going outside on the floor now. He'll break the momentum that Wahoo McDaniel had going for him. And really, in a sense, that's an old football tactic.
Sure, call a timeout if you need to. When Wahoo had him on a roll, he had him going. He was hurting him with those chops. Flair knows that now, going out on the floor, giving himself a breather, cools Wahoo down. He loses that momentum, and he's got to regain it again.
Flair taking his time. Steps back into the ring. Remember, he is the NWA World Heavyweight Champion. He's held it on three different times, which also means he's been defeated twice.
Well, that's exactly right. The old cowboys say there's not a horse that's never been rode, and there ain't a rider that's never been throwed. Well, in professional wrestling, in any professional sport, I don't know of any person or any team that has gone its career and been undefeated.
Another chopping, and it's Flair using Wahoo's very best tactic against him. And you got a war of chops going on now. And Flair stepped into Wahoo's backyard, and Wahoo caught him again. So it looks like Wahoo McDaniel's got that momentum going again. And Flair, again, using time as his ally.
Wahoo McDaniel's hands probably feel like 10 or 12 pound steel plate hitting Flair in the chest.
Flair retaliating, though, caught him with a knee lift into the rib section. And now Flair desperately trying to draw in some air. And Wahoo McDaniel back to his feet, caught with a chop and driven to the canvas. Flair, that's the flat of the foot. Well within the legal parameters of the sport, uses the flat of the foot. McDaniel coming up very slowly. Front chancery now by Flair. Interesting thing about Flair, too. Here is a man who was literally born with a silver spoon in his mouth. Could have taken, I suppose, a lot of easier ways to become a professional in almost any area that he wanted to. But he chose, in my opinion, the toughest sport of all, and that's pro wrestling.
You know, I feel that you made a good analysis right there from a very wealthy family. But, you know, when you've got that aggressiveness, when there's more in life than just earning a paycheck, then if you can do it, if you can be a pro wrestler, it feels so good to walk out of that ring with your hand in the air and know that you've won on your own. And when you get beat, there's nothing more disheartening to know that there was nobody you can blame it on. Nobody dropped the ball. Nobody missed the block. You got beat on your own. And the whole building full of people standing there watching you, it can sure take you down a notch.
Flair just, and I'll tell you what, he let Alfonso know in a hurry, and Alfonso let him know in a hurry. And Alfonso letting him know the title's on the line, and he's not going to put up with any shenanigans from Flair. Oh, I'll tell you what. He's got a lot of intestinal fortitude, Bill Alfonso.
Well, he's got a lot of intestinal fortitude, but on the other hand, Ric Flair would have to be a fool to take a chance on losing one of the falls by intentionally hitting the referee, and that's exactly what would happen. All it would take is one intentional punch to the referee. He would lose one of the falls, which would mean Wahoo would already have won one and hadn't really defeated him yet.
Excellent point and well taken, and it is Wahoo McDaniel with that momentum going once again and again. Flair outside the ring and over that barrier rail. Flair has been stung and stung badly, but there he is, a champion charging the ring once again.
You know, Gene Kaninsky, former world's heavyweight champion, was noted for stepping out of the ring like that. I watched him wrestle my father two or three times, and whenever I thought Dad had him and was going to beat him, Kaninsky'd slide out on the floor. Not only breaks your timing in the ring and your mental thought, but it's just aggravating, and that's exactly what Flair's doing. He's taking advantage of that floor time. He knows that he's got 1 hour. If he can stay out there 1 hour and not get defeated, he's going to leave this building the world's heavyweight champion.
And Flair, although we don't see any evidence, any swelling, but he keeps going back to his nose, and it's possible that one of those chops has broken that nose or else bruised it so badly that he may think it's broken.
You know, that's right. Whenever you're in the ring, your mental attitude and your physical conditioning, and you want to break one of those down, the man in the better shape is usually 9 times out of 10 going to win, because when you're tired and exhausted, you can't think, and when you can't think, you're definitely in trouble.
Beautiful drop toe hold by Wahoo McDaniel as Flair tried to come across with a shoulder block, and McDaniel now cinches down on that leg, and so Flair's got a problem. McDaniel driving the knee into those femoris muscles. And I'm going to be curious to see just how well Flair is going to function on that leg if and when he gets away from this hold.
You know, pain is nothing new to either one of these men. You can see it in their faces. They're two war horses. They're used to being hurt. They knew when they were in the locker rooms getting ready to go in the ring, this was going to be no stroll through the park. They've had some of the toughest, hardest matches that I've ever seen, and they both knew what they were in for. And right now, it's a matter of who is in the best condition and who has the most determination to win. Right now, Wahoo McDaniel's doing exactly what he should. He's trying to weaken Ric Flair, working on his leg, trying to get the man injured, because if Flair can dance and move and stay away from him, he's not going to be able to beat him in that hour. He's going to have to slow Flair down. He's going to have to injure him, and that's exactly what he's doing now.
Flair making it into those ring ropes, and that'll force the break. And that's exactly what it's done. However, McDaniel did not totally separate from him. Brings Flair back into the ring. And Flair having a real, real problem with that left leg. Flair scooting away from him now. Wahoo right back after that leg. And the referee checking those shoulders right down on top of him. I'll tell you what, our two cameramen at ringside are taking their lives into their hands. They, during that Hanson Warrior battle, a couple of them almost got knocked down. But they are giving us tremendous ringside coverage, no question about it.
They sure are. They're in there on all the close shots they can get. And like you say, you never know what these men are going to do. You can have 250 pounds flying out over that top rope coming down at you in a matter of a heartbeat. So they're really doing an excellent job in this filming. And this is footage that's going to go down in wrestling history. Wahoo taking a hard chop to the throat and chest. You can see the pain coming over his face right now, almost like he's stunned and doesn't know where he is.
Snap there now by Flair has Wahoo McDaniel back to the canvas again. And Flair having troubles with that leg, no question about it. You saw him hopping back into that corner. Came down Wahoo McDaniel, playing a bit of possum there, if you will. And rolled right out of the way and went right back after him. A toe hold now on that left leg. That twists the knee once again. Twists the ankle. Puts more pressure on those femoris muscles. McDaniel very definitely pressing this situation. Remember this match, 2 out of 3 falls. Flair finally breaks it up. Now let's watch Flair. He's got some problems. Definitely has problems with that leg. And now really kicking in desperation, chops. And it's Wahoo McDaniel chopping back. Flair's in Wahoo's backyard when it... Good, double leg dive back to the basics.
Up, got his foot up on the rope there, though. He's using that rope for extra, not enough, though. Even with using his rope, foot on the rope, not enough leverage to hold Wahoo's shoulders down.
Now, Wahoo McDaniel, for the last 10 years, has really become a legend. Very rarely does a man have the opportunity to achieve two spectacular professional careers, and Wahoo McDaniel has done exactly that. And it has taken a tremendous amount of self-sacrifice, drive, and ambition. And the champion is dropped again by McDaniel. The champion caught one, right into the side of the rib cage. And one in the, really the only place in the body where there is no muscle, in under the armpit. Wahoo McDaniel fires back against him.
This match has taken an early toll on both of these men. Just constant beating and pounding. The human body is just made to take so much, and these men have gone at it a hard pace. Wahoo knows that he's got to beat Ric Flair, and that's what he's doing. He is going after him.
And it is Ric Flair smashing McDaniel's shoulder into that steel ring post. And I can't help but feel that maybe Flair can feel something that we can't, Mike, and that's that maybe he feels that Wahoo is getting stronger and stronger, and he had to do something a bit desperate.
Well, he's going to have to do something real desperate, because if he goes out and just tries to wrestle a normal wrestling match, he won't beat Wahoo McDaniel. Wahoo is too tough. He doesn't feel pain the way normal people do, and Flair is going to have to get mean, and he's going to have to hurt him to beat him.
All right, McDaniel now caught with a full arm drag and twist by Ric Flair, and it's on that shoulder that just took that severe percussion into the steel ring post. And it is Flair utilizing now and taking every advantage possible. Talking to Joe Pedicino earlier, and Joe is talking about his folks, the winners from Atlanta, who are here at ringside tonight watching. Steve and Judy Sherry and Ralph O'Connor and Ryan O'Connor seem to be pretty well evenly divided as to who they thought would take this match. And Flair unhappy about the camera in his face.
The man with that camera better beware. Flair's not one to play with like that. It's like sticking your hand over the cage of a lion and saying, come on, smack me.
Yeah, you're exactly right. You know, we told you the burner was hot. Don't put your hand on it.
That's right. Right now, Ric Flair in complete control, using his weight, keeping Wahoo pinned to the mat, putting a lot of pressure on that shoulder of which he has injured. It's hard to fight, or it's hard to wrestle, it's hard to do anything when you've got one arm very, very severely injured. Ric Flair knows that. Ric Flair has wrestled injured before. Like I said earlier, this is no new game to Ric Flair. He knows exactly what he's doing. He's got his strategy plan. He knows that he's got to stay in there, that he's got to keep Wahoo McDaniels under control. If a pinfall or a submission comes along for him, that's fine. But it's got to come for Wahoo McDaniels because he has to defeat Ric Flair.
Referee tolling the count on Flair to break that hold. And Flair is using anything that he can do now to continue to punish that left arm. And as you had pointed out earlier on, you concentrate on one part of the body. If you can get that injured or to a point where it's disabled, like the four legs on the table.
That's right. You know, and I know from experience, most of the men I wrestle, of course, are larger than me. But I find that if I can get on just like a 35, 40-pound pit bulldog, we'll get on a 200-300-pound animal and just hang on and hang on and hang on, and he will get that animal down and actually defeat him. It's the same thing in the ring. You've got to get on something and hang on to it and just be determined and have that ability and have that aggressiveness that you know you're going to hurt someone, and either you make them quit or you hurt them.
And that's exactly what Flair has in mind here now as he keeps that arm in prison, floats over the body. And Wahoo McDaniel in a definite predicament here. Able to get those shoulders off, but just barely in time.
Right now, Flair's got him tied up really well. It's extremely hard for Wahoo to breathe in a position like this. He's got him half Nelson with a chicken wing on one side, putting all his weight down on top of him, keeping that arm drawn under him. And Wahoo right now is in some serious trouble. He better come out of that. Best thing he could do is try right there. Right there, he could have single-legged Ric Flair, taken him down, gone back to the leg that he was working on earlier, and at least got a breather, at least let that shoulder rest a little bit.
But unfortunately, that is not the case. And once again, it is Ric Flair, the NWA World Heavyweight Champion, applying even more pressure to that shoulder.
Well, it's easy for me to sit out here and say he should have done this and should have done that. When you're in that ring and it feels like you're about to have your arm pulled off your shoulder, you're not thinking all the time the way you should. So I'm sitting out here nice and fresh in a nice air-conditioned gym looking at this and saying, oh, yeah, he should do this and he should do that. Well, I really shouldn't take that that liberty because it's not that easy.
Well, by the same token, Mike, you have been there, and so you do know what things have to be done, and some things have to become almost instinctive. But right now, it's Ric Flair just issuing an awful lot of punishment to a prone Wahoo McDaniel. And McDaniel, as they say, in a world of hurt right now. There you can hear some of the fans, and of course, Ric Flair, he's got his foot over the rope. Like his entire leg over the rope. That should force the break. And it is McDaniel coming up very, very slowly. Again over that ring rope, and again taking every advantage possible. And Flair now with some forearms into the chest of Wahoo McDaniel. Wahoo McDaniel now taking whatever advantage he feels necessary, and a headbutt that drives Flair down to the canvas.
Of course, that headbutt took a toll on Wahoo too. But in a case like that, when you've got nothing else to lose, You do whatever you think you can to take that advantage.
Flair caught him coming in. And again, Flair goes back to that injured shoulder. And it is Wahoo McDaniel, open chop. Tomahawk chop into the head now that has Flair back into those ropes. Caught him with a chop, and Flair's eyes crossed. Flair's eyes went blank.
Almost for that three count, but not quite enough. He's beat on Flair, pounded on him. He's got all his weight on him. He's got his wrist locked right there, but Flair's still managing to get that shoulder up.
Flair, let's check it out. Apparently had his foot on the rope, and so the referee called for the break. Wahoo broke and gave a little present as he broke.
Right now, Wahoo's slow, determined, throwing those hard, hard chops. Taking a little bit of energy, a little bit of life out of him with each one.
Wahoo McDaniel came from the backyard that time, and Flair retaliates. Well, I don't ever think that Flair can't take it, because he can, and he can dish it right back out again.
Going for the sleeper. Going for the sleeper. This could be the first fall right here.
It could be indeed. Wahoo McDaniel with a sleeper hold on Ric Flair, the NWA World Heavyweight Champion.
Flair's got his head, he's got his head turned just enough. Wahoo doesn't have both sides of the neck. It'll take twice as long to put a man out like this. If Flair can just move his neck, Wahoo's trying to get back into position again. He's trying to get that head back. Flair just keeping that shoulder up enough. Wahoo's arms are a little too big to get in on the neck. Flair blocking it as well as he can. You can see it starting to take effect, though. He's starting to lose that strength. And he knows it. That's why he's going for the ropes. He knows that he's going out.
Desperation set in. But it was too late. It was too late. And Wahoo McDaniel has Flair in a sleeper and down. And Flair has been pinned.
He's got the first fall. He's got that first fall. That's so important in a match like this. Now, Flair, Ric Flair, has got to come back, because if the match ends and Wahoo has won a fall and the time limit has expired, he'll be the champion.
All right, I'll tell you what. We've got a timeout here for the World Heavyweight Champion, Ric Flair, who's unconscious at the moment. We'll be back after these words. All right, well, it looks to me time is returned now, and Mike, it looks to me like Flair, and he's been hurt, is going to have to change his strategy. He's got to go after Wahoo now.
That's right. The whole strategy of this match changes. Ric Flair has now fallen down. He's got to come back. He's got to go after Wahoo McDaniels. He can't lay back and be defensive anymore. He's got to be the aggressor.
All right, waiting now for that bell to ring to start this second fall. And Flair, still staggering, still dazed.
You can see the new confidence in Wahoo McDaniel's face. Through the rest period between falls, Flair was obviously hurt, obviously trying to regain. Wahoo was standing in the corner like the Statue of Liberty with all the confidence in the world. The match has been in progress now 30 minutes. Wahoo's not breathing hard yet. He's in good shape, and he's ready for this match.
Flair watching him with a newfound intensity now as he realizes he's got to play catch-up. He's behind. So the champion trails one fall, misses, and catches Wahoo with a chop that time. Catches him with another one. Forearm into the chest, another chop into the throat. And Ric Flair, grimly determined, misses that time. Wahoo retaliates, catches him.
Going for that pinfall, not able to get it, but I'll tell you, I've seen matches won like that. When the sleeper is used to the point of semi-unconsciousness, it takes a while to get your thoughts back again. A hard blow like that, a stunning shock, and it could have been the 1-2-3 for the second fall that Wahoo needs to win this match.
Side headlock now by the challenger, Wahoo McDaniel. As Flair has to change his strategy, Wahoo really has to change his as well, because he does have a fall up on the champion. Now he's going to have to be doubly careful to make sure that he doesn't make any mistakes.
You know, that's exactly right. You can get on a high, you can be on top of the world and make a silly mistake and get that pinfall against you, and then you're right back to square one.
Wahoo McDaniel keeping the side headlock on the world champion, Ric Flair. Flair, of course, in the red trunks. Wahoo McDaniel in the black. Referee Bill Alfonso watching him carefully now. Alfonso, an extremely active referee. Flair hanging on. And Flair maybe trying to figure his strategy here. All right, gets him back into the turnbuckle. That will force the break.
Flair, of course, using those ring ropes, turnbuckles, and everything to his advantage. He knows that he was caught in a good hold. He is in some trouble. Figuring the only way he can to break it is to push Wahoo back into the ropes. Right now, Wahoo just pounding on him. Deliberate, slow, just pounding the life out of him.
Snap Mare into a rear chin lock. And tried to slide into that sleeper hold again. Flair quickly and desperately moved to those ring ropes. Wow. Flair chopped right over those ropes. And an admonishment here by the referee.
Boy, that's dangerous when you get knocked over like that backwards. That railing around the ring, you're falling, you know, 9-10 feet upside down. Your leg hits that steel railing there on the outside, it's broken immediately.
Flair now pulling Wahoo McDaniel partially outside the ring and then punishing that left leg on the ring apron itself. By the way, that's angle iron underneath the ring mat itself. And now it is Flair punishing that leg against the steel ring post.
Flair using everything he can to try to take the advantage, using the ring post, the ring ropes, the ring apron. He knows the determination that Wahoo McDaniel has. He knows he's not in there wrestling just a normal person.
And it's Wahoo McDaniel, that left leg bothering him considerably now as he tries to regain his feet, and Flair closing in very quickly goes after that left leg again.
Flair can sense that he's got Wahoo's leg hurt, and you can bet he's not going to relax on it either. He's going to stay on that leg. He's going to keep that pressure on him because he knows all Wahoo has to do is get one more fall, and he is no longer the world's heavyweight champion.
Again, Flair going to the ring ropes, and Wahoo McDaniel helpless to do much about it. Flair drops the full weight of his body down across the upper thigh of Wahoo McDaniel. Then disdainfully just kicks the leg to one side. And it's Flair in behind his man, charges him. Flat of the foot, then a chop into the throat. And so it is Flair again. Brash and almost cocky in his attitude. But I would think it is stemming from a bit of desperation.
Well, desperation and the aggressiveness to win. That's what it's all about. And every job and every sport and every field, you want to be the best. If you're not excelling to be the best, if you're not excelling to step up that ladder, then you just don't have it. And right now, Ric Flair knows that Wahoo McDaniels is fully capable of beating him. One more fall, if he loses another fall, he's lost that heavyweight title. And again, money is very important, but pride. Professional wrestling and any professional athlete that is dedicated and trained, they know what pride is. They know what self-sacrifice is to diet, to exercise. And right here in the World's Heavyweight title match, you're seeing two fine examples of that.
Toehold now by the NWA World Heavyweight Champion Ric Flair. Keeps punishing Wahoo McDaniel. And so Flair's new approach, new strategy, at the moment appears to be successful. He's got McDaniel in trouble. And the crowd now trying to bring added encouragement to the challenger, Wahoo McDaniel. You can hear them now, the rumble starting, as they would like to see Wahoo McDaniel regain. Open slaps across the face of Wahoo McDaniel. And as fiercely prideful as he is, He's going into that spinning toe hold and then into that figure
trying
four.
Trying to get that leg down for the figure four. He's got it. He's got the figure four on Wahoo McDaniels. I've won many, many matches with a figure four. Wahoo could very well get his leg broken because I know he won't give up. I know he won't give up. Right now, as big as Wahoo's legs are, he didn't quite get that one leg crossed at a 90-degree angle. He can't get the pressure on the leg the way he should be able to. That's very painful, but the short joint he's got stuck in off there, it's going to be difficult to actually break the man's leg. He can put a lot of pressure on him. He can hurt the ankle, but if Wahoo can get in there, get into the rope, at this time, going to the ropes is not, you know, it's not anything illegal. It's saving that leg, saving the match. Wahoo McDaniels either needs to get to his stomach, which reverses the pressure by putting Flair's knees down to the mat and putting a lot of pressure on his legs. He's either got to reverse it or get in the ropes, because if he stays in this predicament much longer, he won't be able to walk.
And it is Wahoo McDaniel trying to get over to his stomach, and if he can, it may reverse the pressures here. That figure four not quite properly applied. Wahoo is over, and Flair is over, and it is Flair now who feels that intense pain coursing through his body, and it's Flair who gives up the hold.
Right there, my father, the figure four leg lock was his forte. He taught a lot of wrestlers that hold, taught it to me. I've won a lot of matches with it, and you can tell when you put it on, you can tell when you get the man's legs in there just how good you've got it. And you can break a man's leg very easily with it, or just like that, you can hurt him terribly, but you won't make him quit.
Snap there.
I'm trying to push the leg down to get that leverage. If you don't get that man's foot almost over his knee, you can't get the pressure you need. Right now, he's going into it again, just continuing to try to hurt him. But if you don't get that leg down, you're not going to get the leverage it takes to win. Well, of course, blocking that other foot, which right now it's a standoff. Neither man is in any trouble. As long as Wahoo can keep that foot out there, there he's getting it out now. Flair realizing that he's not going to be able to get it done from that position. Wahoo holding on. Of course, Flair having more energy right now. Wahoo has been punished. Flair coming up on top, using those hands to try to tire him out.
Flair pounding away. And McDaniel on the canvas, shaking that head, trying to get those cobwebs free. And it is Flair right back into a snapmare. Takes McDaniel off his feet again. And Flair hobbling a bit down into the head of Wahoo McDaniel. That kind of a percussion may be a little bit more than the challenger can take.
Wahoo's head has been split open with severe punches and knees to the forehead. A human being's head just wasn't made to take that kind of pounding.
And that Flair still that unsure on that leg, and had to fall back and regroup. Wahoo
getting that shoulder up, but you better get up off there, better get that hand out, getting that shoulder just off the mat. Of course, that's all it takes, is just an inch, quarter of an inch, just daylight between the shoulder and the mat, and that stops the count.
And it is Flair down across the head once again of Wahoo McDaniel. Got the shoulder up. One, two,
bringing that head up, bringing that head and shoulder up. A lot of times, Gordon, you get so tired and you're so hurt that you just can't move. But he's moving enough to break that count, and that's all that counts right now.
Suit play by Wahoo McDaniel, hooking that far leg.
Cut him, goddammit!
Ric Flair always hooking the leg, in control of the arm, his weight on his chest, hooking that leg to keep him from bridging up. Wahoo being able to get that shoulder blade up off the mat and save the count. Going in for the stretch. Wahoo's a big man, though. He's big and strong, but Rick is successful in getting it on him, working on that breathing, trying to wear him out. He knows that the time is counting down. He knows the time is counting down. He knows he's going to have to wear him out, and that's exactly what he's trying to do right now.
Wahoo McDaniel withstanding a lot of pain and a lot of pressures. Those muscles are being pulled in the wrong direction. Wahoo McDaniel trapped in that hold, and now you can hear this crowd coming alive as they are solidly in the corner of one Wahoo McDaniel. They'd like to see him break free from this and now do what could be considered almost the impossible thing. That would be to score that second pinfall and take away this end. And
going down into almost a guillotine, a crossbody ride, trying to get Wahoo's shoulders down. Wahoo gets into the ropes and breaks the count.
So Wahoo now utilizing the ring ropes as an ally, and I can't say that I blame him.
Not at all. At this point in the match, Ric Flair's done everything he can do to try to win. He's used the ropes, the ring apron, the posts, and everything else. Wahoo saving himself right there, getting his leg in the ropes. There's nothing wrong with that.
Wahoo chopping back into the chest of Ric Flair. Flair firing with a tremendous forearm, then a chop into the chest. Wahoo fires back again and again. Wahoo, that one came from the backyard and staggers the champion. The champion's eyes crossing.
Almost 45 minutes into the match. 45 minutes of just beating and pounding and tearing and moving. It amazes me to sit out. I've wrestled plenty of hour matches, and when you're in there, you know you're getting tired, you know you're hurt, but you don't realize how long that time is. And sitting out here like we are, it seems like they've been in there for a week already.
Chops back and forth. And, referee. Knocked to one side, caught one right in the side of the rib cage. And it is a Ric Flair, an Irish whip. Wahoo McDaniel hooks him into a slide. He's got him down.
Questionable if he would have had him pinned, even if the referee was there. Flair was moving, his shoulders were up and down. He didn't have him pinned steady, but with that referee not being there, we just don't know. That could have been it.
And it is Ric Flair smashing McDaniel into the ring post. Referee Bill Alfonso finally coming to his feet and is really shaking it, trying to get the thing straightened out in his mind. Meanwhile, it is Wahoo McDaniel outside the ring, having been smashed into that ring post. Wahoo coming up very, very slowly. Flair outside after him once again. Flair pressing his advantage now. And Flair smashing him into the ring post once again. Wahoo back into the ring, and of course that's where Flair wants him.
That's right, you can't defeat a man out on the floor. You can hurt him, you can punish him, but you've got to pin him, you've got to beat him in the ring. Flair.
Count of three. It's all tied up, one fall apiece. One fall apiece is indicated by referee Bill Alfonso, and we'll be back with a third and deciding fall after we pause for these important words. Check the head of Wahoo McDaniel. That steel ring post had taken its toll, and McDaniel has been pretty badly lacerated. Referee checked and asked Wahoo if he wanted to stop, and obviously the answer was absolutely not.
As long as he can able to breathe, he's not going to stop.
Waiting now for the bell to ring to commence the third and final deciding fall of this match. Two out of three falls. Each man holds one fall. One fall each. This is the third and determining fall. And it is Flair charging in. Knee to the rib cage. Tries to set him. Good block in. It's Wahoo McDaniel getting the souffle.
Right now, Ric Flair could be in more trouble than ever before, because you know when you get an animal hurt, or you get a human being hurt, things come out of them that they normally wouldn't do. They respond differently. Their thinking is different. And Wahoo McDaniel knows that he's hurt. He knows that he's going to have to win this match. And the only way he's going to be able to do it is by going after Ric Flair in a whole different manner than he has so far.
And Flair now hurdles him through the ropes and now takes him back. And this time, it's Wahoo McDaniel retaliating. Wahoo McDaniel jamming the head of Ric Flair into that steel ring post. And Flair taking a severe blow to the head. Blocks that time, fires away to the midsection. Wahoo McDaniel fires back at him and drives him into the post once again. Tried to get his hand up there. How effective it was, I don't know. But nonetheless, Flair's face is now becoming a crimson mask as he too has felt the sting of that steel on his head.
That's exactly what I was saying. Wahoo McDaniel has tried to wrestle. He's tried to do everything correctly. Ric Flair's the one that decided to take him outside and run his head into the post. But when he tried it the second time, Wahoo had already been that route once. Got his leg up and blocked it. Flair left himself wide open. And believe me, anybody can run into that post all the times they want to. That pole is not going to move and it's not going to bend. It's going to break whatever runs into it. In this particular case, it's been a pair of heads.
Chop into the throat of Flair, and Flair, the champion, in trouble. Comes through underneath that bottom rope. And Flair now imploring Wahoo not to punish him anymore, but Wahoo McDaniel closes in once again. Flair, the champion, in a lot of trouble now.
Second breath coming in. That second win. Wahoo McDaniel, you can feel it. The people in the building can feel it. He knows he's got Flair hurt. He knows this is a chance of a lifetime. Going back for that sleeper that he won the first fall with. He's got him. If he can just hold him. If he can just hold him.
Question now is Ric Flair. He knows what happened to him early on. And he has to feel darkness closing in as Wahoo McDaniel continues to mount pressure on that sleeper. Flair desperately trying to twist his head, twist his body, get to those ring ropes, anything to break this hold. And Flair.
It worked once. It worked for him once. Is he going to do it? Is lightning going to strike twice? He's going down.
He is beginning to fade. The arms of Morpheus closing. No, sir, he got the that turnbuckle. Wahoo McDaniel not aware of the fact he had that sleeper hold on like a pit bull. He was not going to give it up. I don't believe he was even aware of the fact. He was probably stunned when he came backwards. And all right. Ric Flair has successfully, but perhaps unknowingly, defended his world title. We'll be back with a wrap-up right after these words.
The winner of 2 out of 3 falls and still NWA World Heavyweight Wrestling Champion, Ric Flair.
Well, as you could hear by the crowd's response to that, they were not too pleased over what just happened. I'll tell you what, Mike, I don't think Flair even realized what he had done when he got his foot up on that turnbuckle, but maybe we can take a look at it and see if we can't catch.
You know, at that point in the match, both men were so tired after, you know, almost 55 minutes of wrestling that Wahoo just knew he had him beat. He had won the first fall with it. Flair, his head was spinning from being run into that post, losing blood quickly. You could see the strength going out of him. He knew then what he was doing, to push over backward, but here he's almost out.
I just wonder, we'll take a look at it again, Mike. You know what I wonder here? I wonder if when he shoved back with that leg and Wahoo went backwards, he was carrying 245 pounds on top of him. I wonder if it stunned him temporarily, but he had such a locked position around the neck of Ric Flair that he didn't release, but his own shoulders were down for the count.
Well, that too, he was stunned, I'm sure, but at this point, he had no idea he was being counted. He was in control. He was the aggressor. He was in control, like we said in that earlier match when Hector Guerrero pinned the man. All it was a hand laying on him, but that was the 1-2-3. Right there, Wahoo was tired. He was hurt. He had won that first fall with a sleeper, and he just knew that he wasn't thinking about getting pinned. He lost his position in the ring, and And one of those things, Flair might not have even realized that he was in a pinning position. That's a call that the referee made. It was the referee's decision. It could be...
All right, I'll tell you what. We'll be back to wrap up right after we pause.
Go, John.
10,000 disappointed fans, and I'm sure you are too, Wahoo. What's the future hold?
Well, John, I'm down, but I'm not out. You know, I had my chance. Evidently, I didn't take good advantage of it, but I'll tell you one thing, Flair. I'll be back.
That's all from here.
Gordon Soley speaking on behalf of Mike Graham, saying that our prayers are with the Fritz von Erich family, and we hope for a speedy recovery for Mike von Erich. And for the Battle of the Belts in Tampa, Florida, this is us saying so long.
Meet the U.S.